Wednesday, the 25th of January, and I do hope that everyone's having a good week. Our opening prayer. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above the heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Our readings today are Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 1 to 10, and Acts 9, verses 1 to 22. One of these days, we'll finally realise that God doesn't have a set way of working. Humanly, what happens is we tend to see something which we consider to be a success, and we copy it, hoping for the same outcome. We then wonder why, what does actually take place in our situation is so different from the other one. Yesterday, through the story of Abram and Lot and the division of the grazing pasture, we had an example of God's unusual way of working. He's promised to bless Abram, so we expect that he'll get the good land. But God knows what he's doing. The poor quality land makes it even clearer that the blessing does come from God. Today continues with this theme of God working in unlikely ways. This time, through the choice of person he chooses to do his work. In the case of Jeremiah, it's an age thing. He's too young. Even Jeremiah thinks that. Just think about it. How much notice do we take as adults of a young person who claims to have a message from God? Now, I'm a great fan of young people and how they serve God, but even I might think that a serious message from God should come from an adult. And our other reading is all about Saul, who becomes Saint Paul. He's a sworn enemy of the followers of Jesus, and has a track record to go with it. Saul isn't a person to be messed with. Yet the power of God broke through all of Saul's opposition and defense mechanisms so that he becomes one of the most ardent and loyal of Christian followers. No wonder that people are surprised by this turn of events, and possibly the most surprised of them all was Saul himself. Our reading from Acts was about the conversion of St. Paul to Christianity, and that is the theme of our next prayer. Almighty God, who caused the light of the gospel to shine throughout the world through the preaching of your servant Saint Paul, grant that we, who celebrate his wonderful conversion, may follow him in being witnesses to your truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Our prayer points. Pray for those countries where Christian worship is banned. There's been a recent survey relating to this, and it's really surprising how many countries this includes. Pray for all persecuted Christians, and that they receive special blessings from God. And pray for those who persecute Christians, that God will turn their hearts to him. not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Everyone here at St. Aidan's sends their love and their blessings to you. And our blessing for today. The Father who created light out of darkness, the Son who is the light of the world, the Holy Spirit who enlightens everyone, be with you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.